Hello student, today we are going to discuss about uniform motion and non-uniform motion. What do you mean by uniform motion and what do you mean by non-uniform motion? Uniform motion means if a body covers equal distance in equal interval of time, while non-uniform motion means if a body covers unequal distance in equal interval of time. Okay, you see here, uniform motion means if a body covers equal distance in equal interval of time, while non-uniform motion means if a body covers unequal distance in equal interval of time. Time is always increasing in equal interval. Okay. Here you can see, suppose this is a car, it is moving, okay, and it covers a distance of 100 meter in first 5 minutes, next 100 meter in 10 minutes from initial point. Suppose the initial time is 0 and initial distance I have taken is 0. I have taken initial time as 0 and I have started that counting the time, and after 5 minutes that object covers a distance of 100 meter. Now 5 minutes over, now again 5 minutes after, total time is 10 minutes. So after 10 minutes body covers 200 meter, means up to here 100, again 100 meter. Similarly, in 15 minutes body covers 300 meter distance, and in 20 minutes body covers 400 meter distance. Now the question is how to plot the graph between distance and time, and how to plot the graph between speed and time. By plotting the graph, we can easily determine the nature of motion, how body is moving. Okay, so how to plot the graph? You have to use the scale. Okay, scale, you have to first mark y-axis, then x-axis. Okay, mark it 0 in time 5 minutes. Suppose 1 centimeter scale I have taken here, I will remove. Suppose I have taken in 1 centimeter x-axis, that is time, is equal to what? 5 minutes. 1 centimeter is 5 minutes, next 1 centimeter is 10 minutes, next one is 15, and next one is 20. This is 20. Time is in minute. So you have to mark here time is in minute. Okay, similarly distance is in meter, that's why you have to mark here meter. So first initially it is 0, next 100, 200, 300, 400, means we have to take 1 centimeter in y-axis. What we are taking, we have to take distance. Okay, distance is equal to 100 meter. Means value of 1 centimeter is 100, then 2 centimeter is 200, then 3 centimeter is 300, and 4 centimeter is 400. Now what to do? How to plot the graph? It's very easy. What to do? 500 means you have to use the scale. With this scale you have to draw a straight line, dotted line, like this. Okay, and from this 100 meter, 100, 200, 300 and 400, you have to use scale and mark this point as, like that. Okay, you got one point. Similarly for 10 meter, second point, third, 300 meter, use scale, okay? Don't directly use scale. Here also Now what to do? You have to join the all points. If you join all these points, you will get what you will get? You will get a straight line. This is straight line. Now the next thing is how to find the speed. You note down this. This is important. You have to mention this in the graph paper. Now the question is how to find the speed. Okay, how to find the speed? You have distance time graph and you have to find the speed. Speed is in, you know the formula of speed. Speed is what? Speed is distance upon time. This is the formula for speed. Distance upon time. So how to find the distance? You know, in 100 meter, this interval, suppose you are taking this triangle. See, this triangle you are taking. If you are taking this triangle, means this length is how much? 5. And this length is 100. That's why this length is what? Distance. So 100, this is 100, this is 0. 100 minus 0 upon, this is 5, this is 0. 5 minus 0. 5 minus 0. Okay, 5 minus 0. So what is the value? 100 upon 5. 5 to the 10, 0, 20. So what is the unit of speed here? Unit of speed will be what? Speed is, distance is in meter and time is in minute. So 20 meter, okay, 5 to the 10, 0, 20 meter per minute. So suppose this is 20, this is 40, this is 60. Now again, if you want to find the speed in the interval 5 to 10, any interval you can find, in between any interval you can find. So here you can see the interval, suppose I am taking 10 to 15, I am taking this interval. So this is 10, this is 15. So we have to consider this triangle. So 15 minus 10 is how much? 5. And 100 minus 200 is how much? 100. 300 minus 200 is 100. And 15 minus 10 is 5. So how to find the speed? Speed is equal to distance by time. So distance is 100 and time is 5. So 100 by 5 is same, 20 meter per minute. So everywhere the speed is coming what? Constant. Speed is coming constant. Speed is constant. That is 20. So what to do? As time is goes on increasing, time is increasing. Speed is always constant. That is 20. Suppose in 1, 2, 3, 4, any time interval, speed is increasing. Means speed is constant. That's why we have to join all this point and we will get a straight line. We will get straight line. What is the meaning of this straight line? The meaning of this straight line is that speed is constant. The meaning of this straight line is speed is constant. Clear? In uniform motion, speed is constant. This is example for you. This is homework for you. You have to write in comment box. You have to write the example of uniform motion and non-uniform motion in comment box. Okay. Now, how to find the acceleration? Acceleration is final speed minus initial speed upon time. So final speed suppose V2, initial speed suppose V1, and time is suppose T. As there is no change in speed, there is no change in speed. Speed is 20. That is how much? 20 meter per minute. Speed is constant. It means acceleration is 0. So in uniform motion, body covers equal distance in equal interval of time. Speed is constant, but the acceleration is 0. Example you have to mention in comment and you have to write the definition of uniform motion. You have to plot these two graphs also. Okay. Similarly, now for non-uniform motion. Okay. Let's see. So non-uniform motion means unequal distance and equal interval of time. Suppose any body or any vehicle is moving and covering a distance in suppose kilometer, and time suppose I have taken in hour. Suppose any vehicle covers in 1 hour, it covers 1 kilometer distance. In next 1 hour, that is in 2 hour, it covers 4 kilometer distance. In 3rd hour, means suppose it covers 9 kilometer distance, and in 4 hour it covers 16 kilometer distance. So here you can see that time is increasing in equal rate, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. What is the interval between them is 1, 2, 2, that is 2 minus 1 is 1. What is the interval between them? 3 minus 2 is 1 also. Here also 4 minus 3 is 1. So everywhere equal interval of time is increasing. But now see the condition of distance. Here you see distance is increasing. How it is increasing? 1, 4, 9 means difference is how much? 3. Here difference is 3. Here difference is 5. Here difference is 7. So this is not equal interval. Here the distance is in equal interval. You see 100, 200 minus 100 is 100. 300 minus 200 is 100. And 400 minus 300 is 100. And if you subtract the time interval, 10 minus 5 is 5. 15 minus 10 is 5. And 20 minus 15 is 5. So everywhere interval is same. Equal interval in equal interval of time. Ek important baat main aapko batana chahta hoon. Bahut hi important baat hai. Equal interval of time में body equal distance travel कर रहा है. इसका मतलब ये मत समझना आप कि यहाँ 1 होगा तो यहाँ भी 1 होगा तो यहाँ भी 1 होगा, यहाँ भी 1 होगा और यहाँ भी 1 होगा, यहाँ भी 1 होगा, ऐसा नहीं है. यहाँ अगर 5 का difference है, यहाँ also 5, there is a difference in 5, there is a difference in 5, there is a difference in 5, everywhere difference is 5. Okay, this 5 difference must be same everywhere throughout the time axis. Okay, और यहां भी आप difference देखो, इनके बीच का difference कितना है? 100. In between them the difference is 100. Here also 100, here also 100. Everywhere difference is 100. तो यहां 100 है और यहां 5 है. दोनों अलग है लेकिन दोनों का रेट सेम है. दोनों क्या 5-5 के हिसाब से चेंज हो रहा है, 100-100 के हिसाब से चेंज हो रहा है. तो जरूरी नहीं है कि यहां 5 हो तो यहां भी 5 का डिफरेंस हो, ये नहीं होता है. मतलब सिंपल है, इंटरवल सेम होनी चाहिए. 100-200 हुआ तो 100 बढ़ा, 300 हुआ मतलब 100 बढ़ा, ये इंटरवल सेम होनी चाहिए. दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. इसमें आप कभी कंफ्यूज मत होना. अगर नहीं समझ में आया तो दोबारा वीडियो को जरूर देखना, ठीक है? चलो, नाउ हाउ टू प्लॉट द ग्राफ बिटवीन ग्राफ ऑफ नॉन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन. सिमिलर वे यू हैव टू प्लॉट एक्स एक्सिस. टाइम इज ऑलवेज प्लॉटेड इन एक्स एक्सिस. Always remember, time is plotted in x-axis. So one, now you do one thing, okay? You have to use scale. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? Now what to do? Distance is 1, 4, 9, 16. Suppose I am taking 4, 8, 12. And next one is what? Next one is 16. टाइम को मार्क कर रहा हूं आवर में. क्लियर? कोई दिक्कत नहीं है. मैंने ऐसा एग्जांपल लिया है. एग्जांपल आप कुछ भी ले सकते हो, ऐसा जरूरी नहीं है. अब अपने हिसाब से कोई भी एग्जांपल ले सकते हो. नाउ सी, 1, नेक्स्ट इज व्हाट? 2, 3, 4. इसका आपको प्लॉट करना है, इस पॉइंट को आपको इसमें प्लॉट करना है. तो 1 पे 1 आ गया, मतलब यहां 1 पे 1 कहां होगा? यहां होगा. तो ये पॉइंट ऐसे मार्क किए, ये मिला पॉइंट, ठीक है? ये पॉइंट मिला. नेक्स्ट है 2 पे 4. 2 यहां है, 2 पे 4. यहां से ऐसे इस परपेंडिकुलर ड्रॉ करना, 4 से परपेंडिकुलर, इस स्केल से यहां से परपेंडिकुलर. मार्क दिस पॉइंट. नाउ 3 पे 9. ग्राफ पे आप बनाओगे तो बहुत अच्छा बनेगा ये. यूज ग्राफ पेपर. ओके, 3 पे 9. तो 9 कहां आएगा? यहां होगा भाई. तो ऐसे डॉटेड यूज करना 3 पे 9। सिमिलरली 4 पे 16, सपोज दिस इज 4, दिस इज 4, यूज स्केल, ओके, यूज स्केल, 4 पे 16, परपेंडिकुलर यहां से ड्रॉ, परपेंडिकुलर यहां से ड्रॉ, दे मीट एट दिस द पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन दिस। नाउ व्हाट टू डू, यू हैव टू जॉइन ऑल दिस पॉइंट। सो हियर यू सी द ग्राफ इज नॉट ए स्ट्रेट लाइन, ग्राफ इज अ कर्व। So in non-uniform motion you will get a graph of curve, and uniform motion you will get a straight line graph. Everywhere angle is same. If the angle is same, means speed is same. This is uniform speed, this is constant speed, this is variable speed. That's why I have written speed is constant. Here speed is what? Speed is variable. Everywhere speed is changing. How to find the speed? Speed is equal to distance by time. Suppose in this interval everywhere speed is चेंजिंग, स्पीड हर जगह क्या हो रही है, चेंज हो रही है, हर इंटरवल में स्पीड क्या हो रही है, चेंज हो रही है। सो दिस इज हेयर स्पीड इज वेरिएबल, एग्जाम्पल इज होमवर्क फॉर यू, हेयर स्पीड इज वेरिएबल, स्पीड इज नॉट कॉन्स्टेंट, इफ स्पीड इज कॉन्स्टेंट एक्सेलरेशन इज जीरो, हेयर स्पीड इज नॉट कॉन्स्टेंट, स्पीड इज चेंजिंग, इट मीन्स बॉडी इज हैविंग सम एक्सेलरेशन, एक्सेलरेशन इज नॉट इज इक्वल टू जीरो, यू नो द फॉर्मूला फॉर एक्सेलरेशन, एक्सेलरेशन इज फाइनल वेलोसिटी माइनस इनिशियल वेलोसिटी अपॉन टाइम। नहीं जानते हो तो इससे पहले वाले वीडियो में मैंने एक्सप्लेन किया था एक्सेलरेशन के बारे में, वो सारा वीडियो अच्छे से देखो, ठीक है, ऑल आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। सो v2 - v1 / t2 - t1, सो इफ स्पीड इज चेंजिंग, स्पीड इज नॉट कॉन्स्टेंट, मीन्स इट इज डिफरेंट, देयरफॉर एक्सेलरेशन विल अकर, सो बॉडी इज हैविंग सम एक्सेलरेशन। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट यूनिफॉर्म मोशन एंड नॉन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन।